Washington, 21 Republican governors and one Democrat are taking aim at a key component of President Joe Biden's COVID-19 relief bill, arguing a proposed allocation of funds punishes states that did not fully lock down businesses amid the pandemic. The governors, led by South Carolina Governor Henry McMaster, issued a statement over the weekend critical of what they called a biased formula used to decide how much money in direct aid each state receives. One Democrat, Kansas Governor Laura Kelly, also supported the statement. Biden's bill, dubbed the American Rescue Plan, proposes $350 billion in direct aid to state and city governments to replenish tax revenue collections that declined during the pandemic. Most of the funding for each state would be based on its unemployment figures, not overall population. States where the most citizens were out of work last year would receive a greater share. That arrangement punishes states that took a measured approach to the pandemic and entered the crisis with healthy state budgets and strong economies, the governors said in the statement. A state's ability to keep businesses open and people employed should not be a penalizing factor when distributing funds. If Congress is going to provide aid to states, it should be on an equitable population basis. Biden's COVID-19 relief bill passed the Democratic-controlled House early Saturday morning by a mostly party-line 219-212 vote. It now heads to the evenly divided Senate, where a vote is expected this week. The White House declined to comment. Democratic Party Chairman Jaime Harris, responding to the governor's criticism, tweeted, "There is idiotic and then there is this. SC, wake up." Harris, former state party chairman in South Carolina, touted how the bill would deliver $1,400 stimulus check as well as funding for vaccinations, schools and housing. House Republicans have seized on the funding formula to allege Biden's bill disproportionately helps states run by the Democrat majority's political allies. 33 states would receive fewer funds than if the formula were based on population, according to an analysis from the Office of Representative Jason Smith of Missouri, the top Republican on the House Budget Committee. 23 of the states are led by Republican governors and 10 by Democratic governors. The five states that would see their funding decrease the most are Georgia, Florida, Virginia, South Carolina, and Alabama, according to the analysis. Only Virginia has a Democratic governor. The five states that would get the biggest financial boost by using unemployment as a criteria are California, New York, New Jersey, Texas, and Nevada. Only Texas has a Republican governor. Texas Governor Greg Abbott is not among the 22 governors who signed on to the statement.